next in the tank is an indulgence with a modern twist.
My name is Sabina Lotta. I'm from Dallas, Texas.
Yeah,
I currently live in Los Angeles, California. I'm seeking $300,000 for 10% of my company, Doe.
Wow.
Over the past year, I've started taking fistfuls of supplements. Everything from zinc and elderberry to boost my immune system, to aloe vera and vitamin C for my skin, and even ashwagandha to calm myself down. I may seem like your typical LA health nut, but I love junk food. I mean, I grew up on the stuff. Introducing Doe, enhanced cookie dough packed with vitamins and functional ingredients. A lot of other raw cookie doughs are made with things like refined sugars and preservatives and animal byproducts. Our cookie dough is made with things like oats, almond butter, flaxseed, and coconut sugar. We've added in good-for-you functional ingredients. For example, this jar of chocolate chip cookie dough has the same amount of zinc as 3 pounds of chickpeas. This jar of brownie batter has the same amount of vitamin C as 5 whole oranges. We've made everything delicious, gluten-free, and vegan, especially for you, Mark. Now, Sharks, who's ready to invest and roll in some dough?
What are we trying?
Sharks, in front of you, we have our 4 flavors of cookie dough. You can eat them raw straight from the jar, or you can make ooey gooey cookies. So we've got some cookies for you as well.
Mmm, really good.
So this 110 calories, is this the serving?
Yeah, I would say about that size. We're not really calorie focused. We're focused more on the
ingredients. That's obvious.
Are you a food person? How'd you come up with this?
So my parents are immigrants. And
where'd they immigrate from?
My mom was born in Pakistan and my dad was born in India. My dad didn't have much of an education and he kind of saved up enough money to buy a gas station and he lived there. I mean, 14 hours a day, 7 days a week, like it's a grind.
Wow.
And you know who else lived there? This girl. And so I had all of my meals in that gas station on the weekends. You know, Oreos for breakfast, honey buns for lunch. I would make Kraft mac and cheese in the microwave for dinner. So no surprise, after college, my first job was working at one of the biggest food and beverage CPG companies in the world. But I was going through kind of a health transformation myself and it was just at odds. So I got out of food and beverage completely. And then I went to venture capital. I knew I was entrepreneurial by nature, so I wanted to learn the startup world.
And when did you launch Doe?
I concepted Doe in June of 2020. I launched
it. So you're brand new.
Brand new.
Oh, wow, okay.
But my numbers will tell you otherwise. We did 70K from October to December, and we've done 630K in revenue.
What?
Thus far.
Good for you.
And we're on track to do $1.2 million this year.
How are you selling that much?
And we just got approved at Whole Foods this morning, literally like 3 hours ago.
Congratulations.
Good day.
I know.
How many Whole Foods are you going into?
So it's about 40 stores.
And what are they going to sell it for, and what are you selling it to them for?
And what does it cost you?
So it costs us $3.70 to make, landed at our fulfillment center, and we charge $15 a jar online.
$15
a jar? Wow. Is that a premium?
Yes. It is. It's a premium.
Definitely.
How much money have you raised?
I raised $1 million.
Wow.
Wow. What valuation?
At a $6 million cap.
Whoa. Good for you.
You are impressive.
Thank you.
You know how to sell.
Sabina, 13 years, you're probably one of the most impressive entrepreneurs that stood on that carpet. I wish you all the success in the world. You're incredibly impressive, but I don't like sweets. I gotta really wanna try and eat the product and I eat everything. This isn't for me. I'm out.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
When I look at this, I would love to have it be even healthier because that's just where my mind goes as a consumer. So it's not really the right match, but I think you've done a good job of what you've done. I wish you good luck, but I'm up.
Thank you.
Sabina, there is so much to admire about you. My parents immigrated from India. I felt so close to you when you told that story. What do you think your father would think of you right now, following this entrepreneurial dream and on Shark Tank?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't mean to get choked up. I think he would tell me I'm crazy probably because he did it because he had to do it and I do it because I get to do it. And so he'd probably think I was crazy, but he would be, you know, over the moon.
I bet you he's extremely proud of you.
Thank you.
And you are living your version of the American dream. I would love to back you, but I'm an internet guy.
Yep.
I realize that this just really isn't for me. I'm out.
I appreciate it. Thanks, Nirav.
I too was very impressed, but at the end of the day, I don't eat this kind of food anymore. Now I'm not a kid and now I have to care.
Well, you're, so, I would say, I mean, with all due respect, you're not exactly the target consumer.
Well, I get it, but no,
you're
old,
but
I am.
That's not what I was trying to say.
Yes, you were.
I am the target investor, that's the point. And I'm just telling you, I can't invest in it. I'm sorry, I'm out.
I appreciate it, thank you, Kevin.
Sabina, on one hand, look, we're not your demo, but at the same time, the calories are the calories, and too many kids gaining too much weight is still a real problem in this country. If there was something here that I could hang my hat on to say as an alternative, I'd probably go for it because I think you're incredible. But it's not there, so for those reasons, I'm out.
I guess just one thing before we wrap up. This is the culmination of my career. There is no other person that is more set to scale a business like this than me.
Sabina, you are super impressive.
Thank you.
Sabina, you had a problem reading the room. And that's one of the challenges when it came to you. Whether it was a comment to Kevin, we're not your demo, because you were very clear. But you got to read the room to at least try to make us feel good about who we are and investing. Look, and I'm not trying to rip on her, right?
I don't know. I don't know if that's fair, Mark.
I think maybe it may not be fair. I'm just telling you what I felt.
No, I'll take that feedback.
Well,
yeah,
you can have your opinion. I can look at a product I may not like, but I respect the person.
Oh, no, I think she's phenomenal. I think she's super smart, but it's more the product, right? I don't want to diminish you at all because you are phenomenal.
Sabina, I got to tell you, I just want to back you. I can guide you as the business grows, but I want to be completely honest. Don't come to me and tell me which of the products, or I can't add any value that way.
Yeah.
This is purely an investment in Sabina, and I think you're not gonna fail.
I appreciate that.
I'll give you the $300,000 for 15%.
Okay. I came in knowing I would have to take a haircut.
I'm not gonna negotiate with you.
Would you do $300,000 for 12.5% and meet me in the middle?
Every other person except you, I would almost be insulted by a counter like that. I mean, it's so trivial, but let's reset. $300,000 for 15%. That's my offer.
Would you do 10% and 5% advisor shares?
No, I'm not gonna do it. I wanted to believe in you. Sometimes you make a bet because your heart tells you one thing. I didn't want you to leave without a deal, but I also believed in you and the business.
All right, I'll take it.
No, I'm not gonna do it.
Whoa.
I'm not gonna do it. I wanted to do it, but you don't need me as much as I wanted to invest in you. I mean, I don't. I'm not trying to be difficult with you. I would have been happy to mentor you. But when you keep negotiating me down, I mean, I can't do it. You're going to be fine.
Congrats.
Best of luck.
Thanks.
Congrats on your progress.
Thank you. I'm disappointed, but when a door closes, another one opens, and I just don't know what that door is that's opening yet. You know, this is another no notch on my belt, and we're going to keep going.
I thought I offered her a good deal.
You did.
It's such an important lesson, though. You cannot squeeze that last bit of blood out of the stone.
When five sharks are out, one comes back in, you got one offer, it's not the time to negotiate.
Read the room.